a lot of people have questions on skin bleaching and or lightening, brightening. There is a prescription type of a bleach out there which is called hydroquinone. We know hydroquinone has been banned in many countries. It is banned because they've found it to be cancer causing. So I know that a lot of companies are no longer using hydroquinone in their products anymore. But it is something that is still handed out in a prescription form with retinol. Does it work in lightening the skin? Yes. But the problem that happens with hydroquinone is, number one, it's cancer causing in mass doses. And number two, if you use it for too long, it upsets a melanocyte, a pigment cell. Now, what happens with a pigment cell is there is a cycle, the tyrosinase cycle within a melanocyte. And if you go beyond that 6 to 8 week cycle of using a bleaching ingredient such as hydroquinone, it will upset the cycle and then it will always be upset. So what happens when people first start bleaching with hydroquinone is that initially they notice a difference in that their skin does get lighter, but if they continue to use it, it will start to get blotchy again. So the one thing that you, if you choose to use hydroquinone with a prescription retinol, you can only use it for 6 to 8 weeks, then you must stop using it for at least a month and then you can go back to using it again. I prefer to use other derivatives of hydroquinone that are not known to be cancer causing, which is the alpha-arbutins, the kojic acid, the licorice extract. Vitamin C also has a lightening and brightening effect, and a lot of the pearl powders. So there are so many other great ingredients that lighten and brighten the skin. Of course, our retinols and our alpha hydroxy acids do, that are really healthy and really beneficial on the skin that you can use on a regular basis without having to worry about upsetting pigment cells. So I hope that helps you with your question on brightening and lightening and bleaching the skin.